Well, hi everybody, and welcome to Forbes Riley's Favorite Tips for Success. Today is a quote. It simply states, leap and the net will appear. Now, a friend of mine said, you know, Forbes, if you really do that, you're gonna crash and burn and you're gonna get hurt. And I said, well, that's very funny. How about we take it just a bit more metaphorically? What does it mean to not have a plan B, right? I'll tell you something funny about my experience with the universe. If you set out with a plan and you go full board, but you say, hey, wait, you know, if it doesn't work, I can do this or I can go back to that. Maybe I want to be an actor, but I'm still going to go to law school. Let me tell you something. The universe doesn't seem to work that way. If it knows or if it even senses that you've got a plan B, it doesn't let you get your plan A. Well, here's what really happens is if you've got a little plan B, you're always hesitating. If you had no plan B and you could only go for plan A, how much percentage are you going to give it? 110, 120, 2,000%? Because that's all you're focused on. And let's say you don't achieve it. I'll tell you what, you've achieved something that most people never do. How do you know you're on the right path? Enough people tell you no. No, it's true. If you start telling people your dreams and they're bigger than theirs, they go, yeah, you can't do that. You think going off New York to be an actor, you're gonna be. Let me tell you something. That's why Facebook made delete. You get to delete real people in your life. Going, Mom, I love you, but I can't listen to that negativity. My friends, I appreciate it, but your number in the bank account doesn't add up to what I make in a week or a month. I've got bigger dreams. So this whole leap and the net does appear, that is actually one of the bases for my whole life. I didn't know where I was going. Okay, example, I'm 21 years old. My parents are very home-bodied and they don't want to leave the United States. And I said, well, wait, one day I'm going to be famous. What did I know? And I want to see Europe. And I got this book, Arthur Frommer's Europe on $20 a Day. And I said to my mom, here's my deal. I'm going to see everything in this book and tear out the page. And when I have just the cover, I'm coming home. I freaked my poor mother out. And I just, God rest her soul, I felt really bad. There was no internet back then. There were no cell phones back then. And I lost myself in Europe for 6 months and had the most amazing time of my life. I don't know if I'd let my children do that, but I'll tell you what. What did I do? I went for it 110% and had a phenomenal journey. I've done that so many times. Because I truly believe that when you get in with both feet, there's only one way to go. And for me, it actually is not down, it just seems to be up. I'll give you one last hint though. I have a business plan. It's a very firm, solid business plan. It goes something like this. Dream it, believe it, achieve it. Did you write that whole thing down? Good, okay. Let me go through this real quick. Dream it. Most of you don't dream big enough. I've asked people how much money they want to make in a year and they'll tell me, a number that I made last month. Dare to dream big. Can you imagine just saying out loud, I want to be a billionaire, not a millionaire. I want to be a billionaire. How does most people go, oh, I can't think that big. It feels uncomfortable. You don't dream big enough. And you know why? Because you're not taught to. You're taught that that's bragging. That's too big. We can't do that. Go for that and see what happens. I'm sure when JFK looked up at that little white thing in the sky and said, we can get to the moon. Are you nuts? No one's been to the moon. There's no road. How do you do that? I'm sure when Columbus said, I'm going to go over that water. Well, good luck with that. If you fall over, see you later. But these people did it. They had this dream. Dreams are undeniable. Dreams are visions. Dreams are not normal. And by the way, I do think you should share them and tell people because that's the believe it part. You have to then invest in this dream and believe that it's possible. I tell lots of people, I become a no collector. Oh, Forbes, really? That little SpinGym thing is going to, yeah, okay. I've sold 1.5 million of those little things nobody thought could go anywhere. You got to go on this road once to know that it's real, and then you get to go on it over and over again. So now you're dreaming big, you believe with your whole heart and soul that you can do it, and then there's that achieving thing, because you don't get to sit home and wait for the phone to ring. Achievements are business plans. They are formal. You reach out for mentors, you ask for help, you devote your time and energy to it, and then just watch what happens. Most people would prefer to sit back and watch the rest of the world go by, and that's okay. Because I think the road would be very crowded if all these dreamer entrepreneurs were on it. There's just a few of us, and I'll tell you what, we're living an extraordinary life. Come on, want to come on a trip with me? That's my tip for the day.